The growing economic muscle of the longshoremen soon found political expression when in 1938 they refused to handle scrap iron bound for Japan.
When we shut down ships and we refused to ship oil and scrap iron to Japan when it invaded China, that was a very radical revolutionary thing. I got a telegram from Mr. Roosevelt saying, hey, quit interfering in the good diplomatic relationships between two nations. I put that at the time. But we still shut down the ships. And we said at the time, that scrap iron is going to come back on the heads of American boys. It did at Pearl Harbor.
What you're doing when you do that is to interfere with the foreign policy of your country.
Sure as hell are. That's our job, that's our privilege, and that's our right, and that's our duty. Right.